your girl Stacia Star. Welcome back to my channel. If it's your first time here, then you better be sure to like, comment, share, and subscribe. But if you're coming back for more, what's good? What's up? Happy full moon. I hope you guys are manifesting nothing but beauty, love, light, success, and fortune into your life. So today is episode 12 of Stacia Speaks. I'm a little bit under the weather. No, I don't think it's anything serious. I think it's just the weather has been changing so much in Boston. It's been raining one day. It's been, I was about to say snowing the next day. Father God, don't let that happen too soon. But raining, 90 degrees, and for somebody like me, I get a little upper respiratory issues when the weather changes. But anyways, this episode today of Stacia Speaks is going to be a good juicy one that I need my ladies to lock into. So ladies, lock into this. Get your drinks, get your snacks, get your Parmesan cheese, get your crackers, whatever it is that you like to eat and snack on, and come into this juicy talk. All right. So today's episode of Stacia Speaks is going to be Stop Being a Pushover, Why Men Love Bitches. Okay. Now, I first want to start off saying that when I say bitch, you all know that bitch can be a derogatory term, but it also can be a form of endearment. It's just one of those words in popular culture as well as English language that has more than one functional uses. So I don't want to offend anyone. I'm not saying that you want to be mean, you want to be rude, you want to be just a nasty person. I'm just pointing out some type of characteristics to coincide with this topic. There's been a lot of different YouTube videos on this topic, as well as numerous books and a very popular book that I actually haven't read. I just kind of skimmed through. I will be reading it, called Why Men Love Bitches. I believe it was a New York Times bestseller, and a lot of people really love the content within that book. So the overall idea or theory of this topic is that men love women who are not nice. And now I'm not saying to be nasty. I always say I'm not nice, I'm kind. Okay, you never want to be nasty, you would never want to be a evil, dark, or just overly negative person, but you being out here in this world, ladies, and as a overly nice pushover woman is what's going to prohibit you from really getting the responses and the respect that you need when it comes to your dealings in the dating world. So let's just jump into number one. Pick me's are desperate and easy to manipulate. So why do men love bitches? Well, what is a pick me? A pick me is a woman essentially that is going to do and say anything that coincides with the societal idea of what a woman should be and how a woman should act. Now, I am a modern woman. I'm eccentric. I'm a little crazy. I'm an artist. I'm wild. I'm a rebel. But I also am traditional in my values and my morals. So I'm not saying that you gotta be out here doing crazy stuff. But when I say a pick me, is a woman who really doesn't have a personal opinion. Like, she just does anything to get the attention of men and to make men feel like, oh, she would be a great wife, a great girlfriend. You see pick me's all the time on social media, really just siding with men and everything. Like, no, he doesn't have to open the door for me. No, we can go 50-50 on the first date. No, I don't mind the fact that he doesn't have any money. Like, that's a pick me. Like, you're trying to get picked. Like, pick me. But it's like you're doing too much and it's coming off as desperate. So those type of women are always very, very, very easy to manipulate because you don't have a backbone. You're not giving any insight into who you are as a person and what you stand for. So when men come across you with your pick me ass, they're just like, okay, she's cute or whatever, but it's like she's boring. She doesn't have anything to her and she's easy to manipulate. Sometimes women think that really doing everything that makes them appear to be the perfect wife is what's gonna get them a husband or it's gonna get them a long-term relationship. Honestly, the type of men you will attract from being a pick me is men that will play you, men that won't really take you serious, or men that will really just try to control you because you're so willing to hand over your power out of desperation for wanting a partner. Number two, bitches have a mystery to them. So bitches are mysterious. Bitches are interesting. A woman who is a bitch, and we're not using this in a negative way. A woman who is a bitch is a woman, like, you're not gonna know everything about her. You're not gonna know where she's at all the time. You're not gonna know her next move. She's mysterious. And to any man who, like, really is looking for a high value partner, who's really looking to settle down with a woman, or just men in general, men love women with mystery. Men love a woman that they can't really crack the code on. And women who are very soft, who are pushovers, y'all are the type of girls girls who are running down your whole schedule. Like, yeah, so I'm about to go here and do this, and tomorrow I'm gonna do that, and then I have like about a few hours that I can be there for you. Like, no, why are you telling him everything you're doing all the time? Like, you're just giving him so much availability to your life. When you're giving a man your whole schedule, everything you're doing all the time, it's like he don't gotta make time in his life to try to come towards you, because he already know you at home waiting on his ass. Even if you are at home, ladies, even if you are at home, sis, waiting on him, don't make it so obvious. You could just be home tidying up your house, painting your nails, doing whatever it is you want to do, but don't make it so obvious that you like are interested in him. Like, have some mystery to yourself. And actually, you should have options. You should be out here living your life, going after your goals. But yeah, like, bitches have mystery to them. Like, you ain't never gonna know everything I'm doing. No, because what, that's none of your business. Why do you need to know everything I'm doing when I'm doing it? Like, get out of here. Number 3, independence, confidence, focus, and self-sufficiency is sexy. I don't need you, but I want you. AKA the anti-clingy woman. So this kind of goes back to point 2. So women who are bitches are independent, they're confident, they're focused on their self and they're self-sufficient. Not saying that they aren't trying to leave the space for a man to provide and protect them, but they are working on their goals and they're focused on themselves. Anti-clingy. Men love women who are wrapped up in themselves, because it's like, damn, she's so dope. Like, I want to just be a part of her life. I always say a happy bitch is a sexy bitch. When you're happy and you're living your life and you're focused on yourself, you're just genuinely more attractive. You're gonna come off more high value. Women who aren't doing anything, who aren't doing anything for themselves, are once again giving off a very desperate, I need to be saved energy. And yes, you will attract men, but typically the men you attract and those type of energies and frequencies are men who are controlling and want to control you and kind of manipulate you in some type of way. You know, you gotta have things going on for yourself. Independent, confident, like, that is attractive. Like, a woman who knows her worth, who knows her value, who knows she's the shit, who knows she doesn't need you, but she wants you. That is alluring to a guy. Once again, it comes back to the mystery. It comes back to the confidence, because listen, one of the things that I feel like really prematurely ruins relationships and connections is insecurity. Being insecure as a woman. And I'm someone, I can attest to this. When I was younger, I was definitely insecure when it came to dating. I was somebody that I gave away so much so soon. I was, you know, so open. I wanted to be around the guys I dated all the time, and it just wasn't working for me. Like, I would come off as this very confident, beautiful, interesting woman, but then once when I would start dating somebody, I would kind of put to bed all of my endeavors, everything I was working on, because I wanted to be around them all the time. And that is not attractive to a man, especially a man who is successful, who is goal-oriented, who is about the money. They are busy and they don't want to be around a girl who's clingy. Where you at? What you doing? What are you doing? Where you at? Where you at? Like, if your man is a boss and he's traveling all the time, you don't need to be clocking him every day, asking him where he's at. Sis, you should be busy, focused on yourself, getting your own money, crossing things off of your own life checklist, so that you don't really even care what he's doing. When y'all link up, y'all link up. You know what I'm saying? When we chill. Like, I don't got time to be clocking you all the time, because I don't want nobody clocking me. You feel me? So yes, independent, self-sufficient, able to take care of yourself, able to pay your own bills, able to support yourself. You're not going without food, able to look nice, able to just maintain a certain type of lifestyle that you are looking for someone else to provide as well. It's a great thing about why men love bitchy women. Okay. 4, queen attitude. A woman who holds herself at a higher regard, on a higher pedestal, typically takes better care of herself, thus letting men know that she is the prize. So this just goes back to self-worth. A woman who acts and moves like a queen, who truly believes she is a queen, has a certain type of energy when she walks into the room. Now, I come off very demanding and very intimidating sometimes, but that's perfectly fine with me, because if I'm intimidating to you, that just means that you wouldn't be able to deal with me anyways. So it's like, I know who I am, I know my value, I know what I bring to the table. I'm a queen and I'm not afraid to say that. I'm not afraid to ask for what I want. I'm not afraid to tell someone if I don't like something. No is one of the greatest turns for you to adapt in your vocabulary, woman. No, I don't like this, I don't want to do that, this isn't good enough for me. You have to be able to vocalize yourself and walk like a queen. Always think of, how do you think Beyonce moves? How do you think Rihanna moves? How do you think Nicki Minaj moves? How do you think Michelle Obama moves? When they come in that room, it better be spick and span tidy. You better be on time. You better be tweeting me like the queen that I am. You want women who have that certain energy rooted within them, they know they're the prize. And because they know they're the prize, men approach them in a way like, listen, if they can't get with it, they ain't gonna deal with it. Or they're gonna be like, oh, all right, look at shorty. Let me see if she really about it. Let me see if she really, really about it. Is she really about that life? So you knowing you're a queen, you knowing that, like, internally really believing that you are beautiful, you are divine, you deserve the best of the best, and you're not gonna settle for anything less, you are the prize. And so when men are going after you, you will start to realize, see, let me tell you something. When I shifted my mindset into how I felt about myself and being like, okay, I feel like I'm the shit. I feel like I'm amazing. I feel like I'm a queen. I'm gonna lead my life in this way. Clowns really just stopped approaching me. And at the end of the day, when men would step to me, it would be in a way of respect. I mean, honestly, when I say men really don't come at me in a disrespectful way, I feel like it's because they know better. They know what time it is. Don't do it with me. Go over and play with her over there. Miss pick me over there. But you can't play with Anastasia because I don't play games. Okay? And I guess that could be intimidating in some type of way. But when you are somebody who's focused on your goals, you trying to get money, you're trying to be successful, you're trying to be a multimillionaire, you don't have time for suckers. You don't have time for clowns. And if people think that is, oh, way too much, then I don't really care. Okay? Because I have to do what I have to do. See, women who are bitches, women who are queens, women who know they're the prize, we not pressed for men. We know that men are always gonna be there. We know that they want us. So when you're pressed for men, when you're in a pick-me desperation type of energy, you're just always seeking to be loved by someone else. And what that does is that attracts people who probably will never be able to fill that void, because when you're living in that energy, what you're sending energetically and the frequency you're sending to the universe is that of lack. I'm not good enough. I'm lacking. So what are you gonna get? You are what you attract. You're gonna get people who feel like you're lacking as well. When you're a queen and you're walking in your truth and you know that you're the shit and you know that you deserve the very best, you're gonna get people who are kings. You're gonna get people who respect you. And you might not have a lot, like, listen, when you start to really value yourself, you're not gonna have mad numbers in your phone all the time. Because, like, a lot, like, you're not gonna deal with a lot of people like that, because you're gonna be like, I don't have time. And you have to be coming at me a certain type of way to really get my attention. Respect. Okay? So ladies, be independent, be confident, be self-sufficient, go after your goal at all times. Okay? And that is how you attract people who are gonna respect you and treat you like the queen you are. You are the prize. You ain't no chicken finger dinner. Get out of here with that. Ugh. Bitch ignites the chase in a man. Good men like to work for a woman. Easy women are always passed up. Okay, believe it or not, men like to chase. Biologically, genetically, men are hunters. Men are predators. Not in a negative way, but just in the wild. Like, women are the prey, men are the predators. Men were created to chase. So when a man sees a woman who is focused on herself, who is not easy, who is not giving her time to everybody, who knows she's the shit, who looks good, who's motivated, who's going after her goals, they're like, oh, I like that. Like, and let me tell you something. Men who are successful, men who have money, men who are attractive, throwing their 6 feet and above, throwing their some good, look good, smell good, nice car, dresses nice, they are used to women flocking to them. They are used to women buckling at the knees. They are used to women doing what they say when they want. They are used to treating women how they want to treat them and them still sticking around. You change the dynamic from being the queen and being the bitch. You ignite the chase. Oh, okay, like, oh, so she not chasing me? Like, she really just cut me off? Like, and ladies, I want to let you know this, because there's definitely been times in my life when I've been a little bit caught up, and I like somebody a lot, and I was putting up with a little bit more than I should have been putting up with, but At any moment, ladies, you can switch your dynamic and take your power back, take your energy back, okay? And what that's gonna do to a guy who's, you know, typically these successful men are very used to having a plethora of women at their feet. You know, there's more women than there are men on this earth. So when those type of men, they're very used to women being easy and just being available to them. Even beautiful, amazing, high value women sometimes have this issue of just falling victim to men. And I feel like there was a quote in some movie or somewhere where I heard, like, there's women who have PhDs who be getting played by dudes who don't even have enough accolades for them. So it doesn't have to do with your intelligence, with who you are morally. It really just has to do with your confidence and how you're willing to walk in this world. So when you're the woman who's the bitch, you're the queen, you're the prize, you're gonna send this message to guys like, I'm not chasing you. You're blocked. I don't like how you're treating me. It's not good enough for me. That's my favorite term. It's not good enough for me. Oh, who do you think you are? Oh, who do I think I am? Oh, I know who I am. I'm Anastasia. Thank you. And clearly you know who I am too. That's why you want my phone. Okay? So it's like, ladies, it's not being mean when you're speaking your mind and you're speaking your truth. And for anybody to try to tell you that you don't have the right to be confident, to think you're amazing, that's a clown. Okay? They want you to be stupid. Because like I was saying, going back, you gonna shock that dude. You gonna shock him when you not chasing him, when you not thirsty for him. He gonna be like, damn, like, she not chasing me. Like, she not thirsty for me. Like, what is this? And that's what's gonna make him, if he's really interested in you, he's gonna want to work harder. He's gonna try to crack that code. And two things happen. He might really fall for you in the meantime, or, you know, you guys might not work out, but at least you still stead your ground with your values. You know what I'm saying? Don't be nobody's fools. So when you out here, you know, have some mystery, be the prize, make men work and chase. And even if a guy has everything you want, even if he has everything you want, he is everything you would ever imagine, those are the ones that you hold back from the most, okay? Because those are the ones who ultimately could hurt you the worst. And I'm not trying to tell you, oh, you gotta be like this, you gotta do like that. But ladies, it's 2021. Dating is up out here. You gotta protect your heart, okay? So if that's a guy, you like him a lot, man, listen, I could be in love with a guy, okay? And I would, until he let me know, I'm not letting him know. Now, it's not like I'm gonna be disrespectful. I'm not gonna be playing mad games. But I'm gonna wait and see how hard you wanna take this before I really start opening up my heart to you, because I am the prize. And for me to start giving you all of this ill loving that I have, all of the amazing things that I bring to the table, you gotta give me something. So ladies, if you're dealing with a guy like that, let him chase you. If he wants to take you out, I can't tonight, I'm really busy. Even if you're not busy, okay, can we go like in a week or so? You know, I was thinking about maybe we can go here. Well, I don't really like that place, I'd rather go here. You know, like, men love women like that, because listen, they are so used to girls telling them or being okay with whatever. Like, listen, you know you plant-based. Why you letting him take you to a steakhouse? Like, I'd be like, you know I don't eat meat. Like, this is okay, but like, I mean, I don't eat meat, so I prefer to go somewhere else. You know, like, speak your mind. I mean, they can be like, this motherfucking, you know what I'm saying? But they love it because they be like, yo. Now, I'm saying, don't overdo it. Like, don't take it too far. Don't force it. But you know what? Be starting in what you do and do not like. You know what I'm saying? If you don't like something, say it. If you don't like, see, one thing about me, I really don't like when men are late. I really don't like when men are late. That pisses me off, okay? And so, even though I'd be about 5-10 minutes late, but I mean, I'm the prize. Anyways, I'm joking, but I'm not. So I remember when I was younger, there was this guy I really like, and he used to always be on time. And then I feel like once he started knowing, like, oh, I got her, she liked me, he wanted to start being late, and I just let it slide because I liked him. And so that came from him being late, to him canceling, to him just not coming all together, okay? Ladies, stand your ground and be like, I'm not, even if, see, listen, things happen in life. People might be late sometimes, you know, things can happen, traffic, accidents, what have you, right? Car trouble, whatever. But if it's like more than one time, it's like a pattern, let him show up 20 to 30 minutes late. Okay, you 30 minutes late, yo, I'm outside. Hello? You're outside? It's 9 o'clock, you said you would be here at 8. Yeah, I'm not gonna be able to come. I already took my makeup off, I'm actually like getting ready to go to bed. Yeah, I know, but I mean, I mean, it's too late for me, all right? Just be on time next time. All right, bye. Easy as that. And if he likes you, I guarantee you that gonna be on time. Wasting my time. You don't want to be the girl. See, men be playing with you, trying to see, test your temperature, trying to see how far they could take it. So here you go, Miss Stupid Ass, running downstairs. You've been sitting there for 2 hours waiting on him. Boy, I'm taking my makeup off, or I'm already on the backup tape, but that's another video. I'm not running down the stairs. No, for you. So you, because what that tells a man is that he could go about his day, he could do whatever he want, he could do this, he could do that, he could maybe be chilling with another bitch, okay, and then show up to you when he wants to, because he's looking at you at the bottom, bitch. You ain't no bottom bitch, absolutely not, okay? I know that's right. All right, number 6. Bitches are a sign of good leaders and good mothers. They're not easily fooled and or manipulated. So a woman who is a bitch, a woman who is demanding, a woman who is confident, that woman sends a signal to a man that she's not easily played with. So you got to think about when a woman is a mother, or, you know, how would she lead the child? Is she easily strewed? Can she be easily taken away? If some guy comes around and says X, Y, and Z, can she be played with? Like, you know you can't play with me. You know what type of mother I would be, what type of leader I am, what type of decisions I can make in the household if it ever happens to that I need to step in and take over if my husband can't do that. You know, so that's a great value to have as a woman, is to be decisive, to be determined, and to be able to make decisions without, you see, one thing about me, like, I, you know, people, I guess I do come off as a bitch sometimes, but it's not in a negative way, because I feel like I'm one of the most sweetest, most loving, most godly people you can ever meet. But when it comes down to like business, how I'm interacting with others and people knowing my perspective and my opinion, I'm going to speak my mind and I'm going to advocate that in a certain way. It can, because I work in the corporate world, and just being a black woman in the corporate world, you have to be very decisive. You have to really speak up for yourself. You have to be someone who is able to articulate yourself in order to excel in your career, okay? And so these are traits that I'm not saying to be overly masculine in your relationship or overly demanding, but men love women who are confident and know what they want. Nobody likes a pushover, okay? When you're a pushover, you're gonna get walked over. I used to be Little Miss Sweet Stasia, always getting played, always getting overlooked, always just getting walked over. And it's because I was way too nice. Okay, and I'm not saying you can't be a kind, loving person, but in dealings with men, in dealings with dating, you have to have your guard up, and you have to treat a man and train a man how to treat you, okay? Once he passes the test and he shows you he's all about you, that's when, oh, Miss Loving, baby, what you need? You want some dinner? I got you. I'm gonna make you a bath. You know, that's when all of that comes out. But in the beginning, I need this, I need that, I want this, and I want that. You have to be able to speak your mind about what it is you like. Because if you're not truthful, see, okay, say you a glamorous girl, right? And in the beginning of the relationship, you trying to be nice. You don't wanna squeeze his pockets up. So you're like okay with him taking you to like restaurants that you don't really like to go to. Right, so he's taking you to restaurants and you don't really like to go to. Say you're like a girl who really likes fine dining, and if that's what you like, that's okay if you like fine dining. I like fine dining. I'm a 5-star type of girl, okay? So if you dating a guy and in the beginning you let him take you to Piggly Wiggly's for a 2-piece, and I'm not saying that you can't have your times, because you're not from the streets, I'm still down to earth, but if you're courting me, then go ahead and court, okay? So if you let him take you to these little rinky-dink places just because you like him so much, especially when you know he got money, like, girl, he could spend the money, stop it, okay? Sometimes they just be waiting for you to check their pockets and be like, I want this. You know what I'm saying? You ain't speaking up, you're not getting it, all right? So you doing all of that, you piggly wiggly,
right? You can have a piggly wiggly relationship. You can't come out the bat like 3 months later, like, so why you never take me to Mastro? Why we never go to da 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 da? Why don't we never go to that cute Paris bistro downtown? Oh, because you were settling for piggly wigglies in the beginning. I'm gonna tell you in the beginning, listen, I like this type of food. I like these type of places. I'm not gonna go there. I don't attend those places. I don't wanna be there, okay? This is what I like, and that's just what I like to do. These are the places that I go by myself, with my friends frequently. I live in these type of areas, so this is just what's comfortable for me. And if they like you and they're able to provide that, they will provide that. I'm not saying you have to act skit in a very evil, negative, overly, because I don't wanna confuse when I'm saying men love bitches. I want you guys to go research that book so you just get a little bit of gist of what I'm talking about. I don't want you guys to think when I'm saying that, like, you gotta be mean, like an unbearable bitch. I'm just saying you gotta be decisive and confident. If you're fabulous, be fabulous and speak your truth about what it is that you like and what it is that you require, okay? All right, so this is your girl, Stacia Starr. I hope you guys enjoyed this episode 12 of Stacia Speaks. Be sure to like, comment, share, and subscribe, and I'll definitely be coming back for more. Have a blessed day.